Good morning, my dear professors and colleagues. It's my pleasure and great honor to share with you this lecture about the basics of 3D echo and the added value of the third dimension. Over the last decade, 3D echo has transitioned from a research tool to an imaging technique useful in everyday clinical practice, thus expanding the diagnostic capabilities of cardiac ultrasound. 3D echo may allow a more precise evaluation of cardiac anatomy and pathology that would reduce the subjectivity in image interpretation. Why the third dimension is important? It is important as it provides more additional information that can't be obtained when looking only from one side. And it is always important to look for the other side of the picture. What is the difference between 2D echo and 3D echo? 2D echo provide only a sagittal section of the heart, while 3D echo provide a triangular section of the heart. What is the difference between 3D and 4D? 3D means three dimension, which include height, width, and length. When we add motion, it became 4D. What are the indications of 3D echo according to the American Society of Echocardiography recommendations? The first indication is assessment of left ventricular volume and left ventricular ejection fraction, assessment of mitral valve anatomy and assessment of mitral stenosis, and guidance of transcatheter procedures. . 3D echo can guide structural heart disease intervention such as TAVI, mitral clip, closure of prosthetic valve, paravalvular leak, closure of left atrial appendage, closure of ESCD or PFO. What about image optimization and control before we start the 3D echo examination? The first important item is the quality of the 3D image. Always start with good 2D image. Thus, 3D TE is always better than 3D transthoracic echo. Any 2D artifact will persist in the 3D. The same physics. We have to ensure a good contact of the probe with the esophagus while doing TEE. We have to adjust the 2D image, then adjust the 3D image, and we should be aware of the 3D artifact, such as dropout artifact or stitch artifact. Finally, the proper choice of the appropriate mode for each structure makes a good image. How to optimize the 2D image? It starts with using the optimal gain, focus, and depth. Then focus on the structure of interest. We have to choose 4-beat acquisition and we must acquire ECG-gated images. How to optimize our image in 3D? The first item is the gain control. This control removes the noise from the structure. If there is over gain, we will have a noise or foggy appearance. Can't see what's behind. If there is under gain, there will be a missed part of the structure. The second important item is brightness. This control the degree of illumination. If it was too low, we will have a dark image. If it was too high, we will have a very bright image, which is called over illumination. Scale from 0 to 10, and the most images shows optimal illumination around 5. The third item is smoothing. This control removes the subtle roughness of the surface and makes the structure appear smoother. The fourth item is magnification. This option can magnify the image, and it corresponds to the zoom in the 2D, with advantage of keeping the image quality in spite of magnification. How to control the 3D image? A unique advantage with 3D image is the opportunity to freely rotate and display it in any orientation. And the rotation can be done either online or offline. We can control the 3D image using the following. The first item is Rotate Z option, which allow us to rotate the image clockwise and anti-clockwise. The second item is 3D rotation, to rotate cranial or caudal, front or behind. You can get two different perspectives, for example left atrial and left ventricular perspectives for the mitral valve. In this practical example, we can see the mitral valve from left atrial and left ventricular perspectives at the same time. The third item for control is lateral steer, to move the image and the sector without movement of the probe. And the fourth item for control is swivel motion, which is like the pendulum clock, to compare two structures at the same time. What are the modes of 3D echo in comparison to the modes of 2D echo? In 2D echo, we have 2D, M mode, pulsed wave Doppler, continuous wave Doppler, and the color Doppler. The corresponding modes in 3D echo include X-plane mode, 3D life, 3D zoom, full volume, and full volume with color. The first mode is X-plane mode. This mode provides two orthogonal planes in single image, for example, short axis and long axis. It gives two images, the original image to be to the left and the orthogonal image to the right, and both images are complementary. What are the value and uses of X-plane mode? The first value is to guide the needle in septal puncture, in atrial septostomy during balloon mitral valvuloplasty, guiding the TAVI procedure, Watchman device implantation and the mitral clip, accurate assessment of mitral valve area, confirmation of the left atrial appendage thrombus seen in two orthogonal views is diagnostic. What is the advantage of the X-plane mode? The first one is it provides good spatial and temporal resolution, save time, and it is real time. And the disadvantage is decrease in the temporal resolution when you add color due to decrease in the frame rate, and it is a 2D picture, however, it can't be obtained except with 3D. Let's see this practical example for using the X-plane mode. This is a TE study, and we can see on the left the original image multi-lobed right atrial mass arising from the right atrial free wall. It was angiosarcoma. And on the right, we can see the orthogonal view, which is a bicaval view. And we can clearly see that the mass is extending to the superior vena cava and causing superior vena cava obstruction. The second nice example for using the explain mode. This is a TE study. On the left side, we can see a mid-esophageal view, short axis level. We can see a detached amblatzar ASD closure device from the aortic rim, while on the right side, it looks stable in the SVC and IVC rims. And this is another example for the importance of the explain mode. On the left side, we can see a heterogeneous shadow in the left atrial appendage, suspicious for thrombus. However, when obtaining the orthogonal view, we can clearly see the horizontal muscular ridges of pectinate muscle, so thrombus is excluded. The second mode is Live 3D. Live 3D is a live transmission and real-time image, and this modality refers to acquisition of bramial section. What about value and uses of Live 3D? It is used in intervention in which there is a rapid movement. Theoretically, can be used for imaging of any cardiac structure. However, the aortic valve is the most suitable structure to be visualized by the Live 3D, and the best mode for TAVI is Live 3D. What is the advantage of Live 3D? It gives us the sense of depth, and it provides adequate frame rate. It gives us a real-time 3D image, and it provides a high temporal resolution. The disadvantage include less spatial resolution and poor temporal resolution with large image. This is a practical example for Live 3D showing a huge aortic aneurysm obtained from transthoracic echocardiography parasternal long axis view. And this is a nice example for aortic valve infective endocarditis with filial non-coronary cusp. And in this example, we can see normal anatomical structure, including Eustachian valve and IVC and right atrium and tricuspid valve. And this is a very nice example for two kissing vegetations in the septal and anterior tricuspid valve leaflets, tricuspid valve infective endocarditis. And in this example, we can see a huge mass attached to the interatrial septum at the site of fossa ovalis, and it was a case of right atrial myxoma. And this is a normal anatomical structure. This is a short axis view at the level of great vessels showing the aortic valve, pulmonary valve, and the pulmonary artery with its bifurcation. The third mode is 3D zoom. 3D zoom is a mode that used to show the details of part of a structure by taking a pyramidal sector. What are the uses of 3D zoom and what is the value of the 3D zoom? It is used for assessment and guiding the intervention of left atrial appendage, either Watchman device, or for assessment of left atrial appendage thrombus, mitral valve and the surrounding structures, including assessment of perforation, cleft, flail, prolapse, suitability for mitral valve repair, or mitral clip. The other uses and value of 3D zoom is assessment of interatrial septum and the surrounding structures, assessment of adequacy of the ESCD rims before the device closure, accurate assessment of the size and the number of defects, and the proper choice of the adequate device size for ESCD, and assessment of residual shunt and detection of device embolization. The advantage of 3D zoom is it provides a high spatial resolution, so can give the best anatomical details, while the main disadvantage is less temporal resolution when compared to the live 3D. Let's see this example. We can see here a mass attached to the base of the posterior mitral valve leaflet from parasternal long axis view, transthoracic echo study. After obtaining the 3D zoom using the TE, we can clearly see that the mass is related mainly to the mitral annulus in front of the posterior mitral valve leaflet, and it was finally diagnosed as a case of Lippmann Sachs endocarditis secondary for antiphospholipid syndrome. The second example is on the left side we can see the detached and bladder ESCD closure device from the aortic rim and stable in the SVC and the IVC. And after obtaining the 3D zoom, we can clearly see the device with its full dimensions and its relation to the whole anatomical structure. Another example, in this example we can see two defects in the interatrial septum with evidence of left to right shunt by color flow. After obtaining the 3D zoom, we can clearly see the two defects and the evidence of interatrial septal aneurysm as well. And this is a nice example for tri-leaflet pulmonary valve. This is can't be obtained except with 3D. We can't see the three leaflets of pulmonary valve with 2D using the 3D zoom mode. And in this example, we can see a paravalvular leak of mitral processes TE study. After obtaining the 3D zoom, we can clearly see the defect between the mitral annulus and the mitral processes at about 1 o'clock. And when using the color 3D, we can clearly see the paravalvular leak of the mitral processes, the red flow marked by arrow, the flow outside the ring of the processes. The last mode of 3D echo is full volume. What is the definition of full volume? It is the mode that takes a large pyramidal sector of the heart. It records the image on 4 levels. On each level, the machine puts its strength on a certain part of the heart. The machine automatically stitches the 4 parts together to make the full heart. It takes the average of 4 beats or 7 beats if there is atrial fibrillation, and it must be ECG gated. What about the value and uses of full volume mode? It is used mainly for assessment of left ventricular volumes and function. Full volume with color used for assessment of paravalvular leak, dehiscence, and rocking of metallic processes. The advantage of full volume mode is it provides a high frame rate with high temporal resolution. It provides a high image quality. The disadvantage is it is time consuming, not suitable during the intervention, not real time, and the stitch artifact. In this example, we can see the use of the full volume for assessment of the left ventricular ejection fraction using the left ventricular volumes. And this is another example for use of full volume with color in a case of mitral incompetence. So my take-home message, 3D echo has emerged as an excellent imaging tool that provides an incremental value over the traditional 2D image. With transcatheter interventions being performed routinely across the globe, 3D echo plays a major role in device sizing and periprocedural monitoring. The quality of the 3D images always start with good 2D image, the proper choice of the appropriate mode for each structure makes a good image. Thank you.